Welcome to Mishnah Sadeh Masechet Pesachim Perek Zayin Mishnah Aleph. Well, here continuing with the Korban Pesach, and now how to roast the Korban. Practically speaking, what do we do? So we know we have to roast it, and we're not allowed to cook it, right? Al tochelu menuna uvachel mevuchel b'mayim, right? That's just negative. You can't eat it raw or cooked, right? You're not allowed to eat it cooked. Akiim tzili esh roshu al kina'a ve'al kibbo. Right? It has to be roasted in a fire. So ketzat zulim to Pesach. How do we roast this Korban Pesach? So shefod shel rimon, right? Take a skewer from a pomegranate branch. Now, a pomegranate branch, it itself does not, I guess, let out water and or any you know moisture when it's roasted, right? It really it's a very dry, dry branch, or it's not going to release any of the liquids inside, right? So over here, it's not going to cook that liquids even when it's roasting. That's why we chose pomegranate branch. Right, you stick it in from its mouth all the way down through its butthole on the other end. You take the legs and the innards, the inside of the animal, and you place it inside the animal itself. Rabbi Akiva argues, then the intestines, when they boil up, they're going to actually cook the Pesach from the inside. Rather, what do you have to do? Right? You actually have to hang, right, the legs and the innards outside of it and roast this whole thing on this pomegranate spit. And you take the whole spit, yeah, right, and you place it in a fire, right, in a furnace, fire. And that way, you roast the entire animal, and every part of the animal gets roasted. And halacha is like Rabbi Akiva, right? They have to place the legs and the innards outside of the animal. Obviously.